Hey guys, this is Meadows from Awaken Realms, and welcome to yet another tutorial, this time on how to paint a hero. This is actually a model of Vampire Hunter by Seaboar Monstrous Miniatures. This hero is actually part of a zombie diorama, so if you want to take a look at the full tutorial on how to do this kind of awesome scenery, check out the link in the description. First, I would like to talk a little about the color scheme I have chosen for this hero. Proper colors are very important, and in order to compose this hero into the zombie diorama, I have decided to go with grays and browns to blend with rest of the zombies, rocks, and wooden parts. I also added reds and oranges to match blood and rusty metallics, and blue for coat to add a little bit of cold colors for contrast. Thanks to that, all parts of diorama complement each other, but you are more than welcome to try your own colors and experiment a little bit. First layer will be Dark Reaper. I'll be painting whole model from the top. It's like a zenithal highlight. I'll just paint mostly everything, just leaving a few shadows unpainted. And same for the head. Next is Storm Vermin 4, and this is a highlight. and again, same for the head. Another highlight of Celestial Grey. Now I'll be using black to paint skin and a few other clothes black again. Dryad bark for clothes, bags, few stripes and a gun. Cut on flesh tone for head and hands. Dark Flash, it is an old paint, a new one is called Dumble Brown, and I'll be painting all clothes and bags with it, but I will leave shirt brown for now. Now, Screaming Skull to highlight basically everything. I'll be highlighting skin, weapon, clothes, coat, and bags. By the way, I've got a joke for you. Why is an elephant big, grey and wrinkly? Because if it was small, white and smooth, it would be an aspirin. Now trim it white, and I'll be highlighting hat and all the other parts of the hero. Now I'll be using water down Dread Bark to paint over a few stripes and about. I'll be using Raycan Flesh Shade to wash over skin and trousers. The last part was out of focus, so I removed it, but I have also painted over face and other hand. Now edge highlights on the whole model with Screaming Skull. I apologize in advance, this step is a little bit out of focus on the beginning, but then there's a few more minutes of doing edges in focus, so if you want you can just skip 1 minute ahead and we should be fine. Just a little bit of art coat, a very thin layer to protect the model before next steps. It is not necessary, but I sometimes do that. Agrax Earthshade for shirt and the other bits. Drakenhof Nightshade, and I'll be washing whole coat with it. Henna's gold for buttons and a few ornaments and weapon and other bits. Runefang Steel to highlight all golden parts and to paint the blade. Null oil to add a few more shadows. white for eyes. And black for eyes. Now, typhus corrosion to add a little dirt. And the rust powder to add a little more color to the art. Finally, blood for the blood god to add blood effects on blade. Thanks for watching. We hope this tutorial was helpful and fun for you. If you like it, we encourage you to watch our other free video painting tutorials. If you want to know how to build whole diorama featuring this hero and bring it to life from scratch, watch special 2 hours video tutorial of Zombie Apocalypse Diorama. You can find the link in description. Happy painting and see you next time!